He's been called a man of many hats, and rightfully so. Dean Richards started out as a lottery and booth announcer at WGN and has appeared on every broadcast the station has ever produced.
Including Daytime Chicago. Oh. This is his first appearance, and he's joining us now to help us celebrate WGN's 75th anniversary.
No wonder I'm so tired.
I finally figured out. I always wonder where you get the energy, because you still stay up late.
Yeah.
You watch all the award shows, so we don't have to.
We see the movies and the plays.
Yes. And exactly, junkets and everything. And then you still do radio and you cook and all this other stuff.
Yeah, my dad said, and probably a lot of parents said, find something that you love doing and you'll never work a day in your life.
Okay.
Because you enjoy it. And I'm super lucky that I get to enjoy most every day of my
most every day. We all have exceptions.
Got a few celebrities that we interviewed were not so enjoyable.
Yes.
I want to start, though, because any of us who grew up in Chicago remember hearing your voice on the Victory Auto Records commercial that still runs to this day.
Still runs to this day. 32 years later.
Wow.
When I was hired as the booth announcer, as they are called, the guy that does the commercials, the guy that does the Brock to You buys, all that sort of thing. One of the very first things I did, my very first week, it's now 32 years ago, was this Victory Auto Records commercial. They changed it a couple of times when the area codes changed, but for the most part, it's been exactly the same thing, and I'm hoping that'll be the first line of my obituary.
Oh, man.
Do you get any money
for it? Dean Richards, best known for...
Right.
The old car may be worth money.
I mean, do you get paid for that still?
No, I got paid
a daily rate. Wow. I know you'll be shocked to hear that there are not residuals for 32 years, but I got paid a daily rate for it for that day, and that was it. The guy who the door falls out on, his name is Bob. He was a tow truck driver for Victory Auto Records. He got $25.
Wow.
For
That commercial has lived on forever.
I wasn't even the first guy on it. Carl Grayson was on it, Floyd Brown. They were the booth announcers before me.
Wow.
So that commercial is legendary in Chicago.
Yeah, talk about legendary. The interviews that you have done, the people you have met, the people you have talked to. But I know one of your favorites is when Tom Hanks actually came here to WGN.
Yeah, fortunately, I mean, one of the good things about doing this for so long is that you kind of have a relationship with a lot of the A-listers now. So when Tom was coming through to promote his movie, Larry Green, I think, was the movie he was promoting. I said, you know, we want to do something a little different. We didn't tell him exactly, but I said, just play along with us. And we dressed up a lot of our staff. That's Mike Jansen, actually.
That's so funny.
He's there. But we had our staff dress up as roles that he played in different movies along the way. And he just has such a good sense of humor and is such a nice guy. My favorite part is coming when he comes to the end of the hallway here. And there's from Apollo 11. But then he turns the corner and the legendary Muriel Clare is coming down the hallway in the other direction. And he looks at Muriel Clare, who you'll see here in a second. And he goes, now, there's Muriel in the background. And he goes, now, who are you supposed to be there?
This is the movie where you play Muriel Clare.
He's such a good guy.
You got to be careful when you walk in the hallways around here. You never know when that's a camera.
In the morning, you never know what's
going to
happen in the hallway. We've had cows in the hallway. We've had, name it, we've done it out in the hallways there.
Yeah. Do you ever, a lot of us know about a couple of tougher interviews you've had with some of these celebrities. Is there one that's most memorable to you?
Well, the one that people ask me about most often is Mel Gibson.
Mel Gibson.
Because he thought we were off the air when we were not off the air, and he called me an a-hole.
Colorful language.
And it went crazy viral back in the day. Since then, I've interviewed Mel Gibson a couple of times since then, and everything is fine.
But that
went viral, so everybody remembers that. But we had Deborah Winger walk off the set, take her microphone off, throw it on the ground, and walk off the set down in the studio. She just didn't want to be here, and she didn't like video that we were showing. It was just one thing after another.
There have been
a handful. Tommy Lee Jones is the most famously difficult interview.
Really?
Because he purposely will give you one word answers just to throw you both know as interviewers, somebody gives you a one-word answer, you were not expecting that.
No.
And dead silence afterwards. Yeah. He does that all the time.
Wow.
So I knew about it ahead of time. I was ready for it. But, yeah, 99% of the celebrities are great. They're really fun. They know the bald guy from Chicago now. So it's gotten much easier with longevity.
Yeah.
And you recently added a new skill to your array of things.
This is crazy. I brought you some of the cannolis that I made on our show, on the morning show today. I was doing a segment on food from the movies. And the famous scene from The Godfather is when he goes, leave the gun, take the cannoli. So I thought I'd make some. They're so easy to make. The recipe's online at WGNTV.com/DeanCooks. So you can make your own, super simple, and according to all the crew and half the people in this building that just miraculously stop by the studio every Wednesday, everyone seems to have enjoyed them. So I brought you guys.
Oh, yeah.
I brought a plate. I never go anywhere without making a plate.
I'm asking everyone on these interviews, what do you think is the reason that WGN is so lasting in the community and the memories?
Well, it's because of Chicago, but it's because it's real also. Mm-hmm. You'll notice the difference. There's a complete honesty, warts and all.
Yeah.
You know, there's no better example of that than our morning show, mm-hmm. where, you know, somebody's calling somebody else a name, and things will drop and break and fall. Yeah. Things happen.
Yeah.
And on most stations, you would try to cover that up, or you'd put a big smiley face on it and pretend like everybody loves everybody. Turns out we do actually love one another.
It's like a dysfunctional
family. Most days.
The island of misfit toys.
Yeah. But I think it's the complete honesty, and that people can relate to that. I also think that, unlike a lot of stations, so many people here are truly Chicago's very own.
Yeah.
You are, I am, Robin is. I mean, the list goes on and on of people who are born and raised here. We not only work here, but we take pride in the fact that this is where our family is, this is where our friends are. You know, there's something more to it, and I think for the viewers, it translates.
Yes, I 100% agree. These are delicious, by the way.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Wow.
And all of your community work, we can't go on into that, but all your work with AIDS, Chicago. Yeah.
Breast cancer.
And yes, absolutely. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we've done a lot of good things. Thank you for having
me.
Thank you,
Dean. We appreciate it. Yes. Love the cannoli.
Yeah, especially because you made the cannoli.
Leave the gun, take the cannoli.
Yeah, there you go. All right.